is Alexey. I'm glad to participate in the project and to invite you to this the Best Heritage Imagine series of interviews. And my first question is, can you just describe the project, the how it came to be, what's your role in it, and what was the ideas behind it, and how it was developed?
Well, first of all, I would like to thank you on behalf of the Diachronic Museum of Larissa for inviting us to this event. And I will start from your first question, Sally, saying that the Man Creates Man project includes a short film which has been produced in order to present a spectacular find of the Diachronic Museum of Larissa. And this spectacular find is a small clay house model which came to light after excavations in a Neolithic settlement in the region of Thessaly in Greece. And it is very old, since it is dated around the middle of the 6th millennium BC. The film was produced in order to be screened during a temporary exhibition our museum has organized together with the Archaeological Museum of Thessaloniki. This temporary exhibition is called Idol, a World in Micrography. I think it is important to say, to give you some information, because Thessaly has always been the epicenter of the Neolithic research in Europe long ago, partly because in this region there appeared some of the oldest Neolithic settlements in Europe, around 6,600 BC. Now, turning to the house model itself, it contained 9 small human movable figurines, and also it shows some of the house equipment, like an earth, a grinding stone, and a platform. But let me tell you that the most important thing was the way it has been found. So it was deposited very carefully and very deliberately in the burnt rubble of a house around the middle of 6th millennium BC, as I told you, and has been associated with a special ritual according to the archaeological evidence. We believe that this house model intended to signify ritually the end of the life cycle of a house. I mean, its abandonment, and simultaneously to bless the well-being of the new owners who have built a new house above it.
And what was the rationale and aims of the Thessaly project itself, the creation of the video, and how was it designed to be viewed by the public?
This project was to contribute to a better understanding of the Neolithic art, and in this case we are talking about Neolithic figurines, for the visitors of Neolithic exhibitions generally. Neolithic figurines are not being seen as artistic objects. Unquestionably, their value is very well known. But we focus primarily on their meaning. So this house model, through its thorough archaeological analysis, has provided good evidence for us to try to envisage the motivations behind the decision of the Neolithic farmers to create it, and to try also to unfold some aspects of their ideology, their thoughts, their feelings.
And what do you think were the particular qualities of the projects that jury decided is worth it, and what's the thing that made it stand out?
The combination of things, actually. The way the filmmaker Yotis Vrantzas has animated vividly the atmosphere of the domestic environment of a Neolithic settlement, what this would be like, based on the lengthy discussions we had together. Also, the way he used the light, the shooting angles, the sounds, the music, and all this together with the poetic gaze and, I would say, the laconic text of the script writer, Katerina Bolmati, which favors soothing moments of silence. That is, I think, obvious.
Yes, yes, I can get it. And,
and this, despite the short duration of this film, which lasts 6 minutes something.
And while you were creating the project, what were the difficult parts and what were unexpected positive sides of the project that you were probably not aware when you were starting with?
Well, if I may speak of everyone involved in this project, I would say that all of us really enjoyed the participation, the collaboration, and the friendly atmosphere during the realization of this project. From the point of view, more specifically, of an archaeologist like me, I would say that the demanding requirements of this work helped me think better and broaden my insights on various topics, and more specifically, I would say, on how such kind of works using this new technology could complement the experience of the visitor of a museum along with the exhibits of the museum itself. On the other hand, I would say that the COVID-19 pandemic, quite ironically, has given us extra time to improve parts of the film. And so, in this way, it was, I think, positive, if I may say so. For us.
That was unexpected. And speaking the creation of the objects themselves, in the film, you not just show the objects, the people on the screen actually recreate them. And so you had to come up with the techniques to actually recreate the figurines, probably as they were created in reality. Was it hard to come up with a technique to make it believable?
Well, surprisingly, not as much as one might think, simply because the maker of the figurine is himself an artist, a sculptor. So it was a wise decision made by the film director, Yotis Vrantzas, who has found him and invited him to this project, knowing that with his own expertise, could follow quite easily the prehistoric techniques of how to make figurines. So this was a strong leverage indeed in this project. On the other hand, some minor difficulties, I would say, appeared in terms of how to teach the children's role. But the director overcame this in a very efficient way. And to be honest, the daughter of his really has had a crucial role in this film.
Speaking of this artist involved, was it the experience for him also somewhat special to be able to recreate the old tradition in his artistry?
He tried, hard, of course, we have sent to him some essential things that he should think of them, and then he proceeded freely because, as I told you, he has had the expertise and the know-how. So this came almost immediately to him, and the result was, I think, very successful. And we've been also very much surprised seeing that.
And in more general way, what led you to the decision to work with a slow building emotions? Because even in the short span of the film, you use laconic script, as you mentioned, less words, more emotions and expectations, rather than usual way of providing additional context, information, etc.
Yes, you are right. So we decided from the beginning to convey the concerns, the feelings, the fears, the aspirations of the Neolithic people as much as we could. And for this reason, we decided to avoid technical details and other information of this kind. So we've been very much focused on this direction. So the slow pace of Neolithic life generally, the interconnection of the ritual and the secular in the daily life of these people. All this required a slow pace of shooting for the viewer to have time to think and absorb the meanings. Also, I have to say that from the beginning, we aimed to raise concern and awareness regarding the relationships of today's people with nature. And I think this environmental approach, I would say, is very characteristic and very obvious from the very beginning till the end of this film. So much so, I would say, because today we are witnessing this deterioration of environment and the climate change, partly due to human interference.
So you wanted to give back the feeling of connectedness that was inside us, the Neolithic way of life, in a way? In
this. Yes, and simultaneously to make a critique about how we today think we are acting as in regards to nature, the environment, and how we violate, I mean, basic things, which, of course, has a radical impact in the long term.
And to create this feeling, how the movie, the film was displayed in the exhibition? It was some specified area or?
The exhibition of the film, as I told you, is taking place in the room of the temporary exhibition, mm-hmm. Entitled Idol, A World in Micrography. So it is being played into this room, and so the visitors of the museum could see it so simply. And their reactions are very positive till now, because they feel relaxed after that. This is what I could say. And this is one of the advantages in the end of this film. We've been very much puzzled to catch the environment of the Neolithic settlement itself. And so, in the end, I would say it has been a combination of places according to the needs of the film, as the director has decided.
Probably there was this small question. The children played some kind of game with bones. What is the game? Is it actual game or was it something invented just for the film?
No. It is really an actual game. We called it knuckle bones. Knuckle bones are the small bones from behind legs of sheep and goats. So the player drops up the knuckle bone, and depending on the side it rests after its fall, the player gains a small amount of points. This is the most common variety of this game, because there are many varieties. And when it happens that the knuckle bone stands on the narrow side, which is very difficult, then the player earns the maximum of the points. We are not certain if this game was in use in Neolithic times, but has been played until a few decades ago here in Greece. Also elsewhere, as far as I know. And also, let me tell you that it was very well known in ancient classical times, and has been played both by boys and girls. And sometimes knuckle bones are found inside the graves, indicating that their owners were very fond of this game, and I would say of high esteem.
That tells something about this film, when you leave some unanswered questions, but they pique interest of the viewer, for I didn't know what was happening, but there was something that became interesting that like makes you question things.
I would say, in the end, we are very satisfied seeing the result of this short film, and it has been the result of a very effective and productive collaboration of everyone participated in this project. And let me tell you that there has been a constant and a mutual exchange of feedback. And so, no matter of the role you have had in the production of this film, everyone in the end, I think, became wiser, I would say.
Yes, thank you.
As always.
Yes, that's the intention. Okay, thank you very much. I think we've covered all the bases here.
My pleasure, and thanks a lot.